I'm Hermione Granger. And you are?
Ron Weasley.
Pleasure.
Hermione Granger.
Okay,
mental, that one. I'm telling you.
You don't use your eyes, do you? Didn't you see what it was standing on?
I wasn't looking at its feet. I was a bit preoccupied with its head.
Now, if you two don't mind, I'm going to bed before either of you come up with another clever idea to get us killed. Or worse, expelled.
She needs to sort out her priorities.
Look, stop, stop, stop. You're going to take someone's eye out. Besides, you're saying it wrong. It's Leviosa, not Leviosa.
You do it then if you're so clever.
Wingardium Leviosa.
It's Leviosa, not Leviosa. She's a nightmare, honestly. No wonder she hasn't got any friends. I think she heard you.
Fatty Patel said that she wouldn't come out of the girls' bathroom. She said that she'd been in there all afternoon, crying.
Oh, my goodness. Explain yourselves, both of you.
What it is, it's my fault, Professor McGonagall. Petrificus totalis.
You're a little scary sometimes. Brilliant. Scary.
This is light.
Just relax! Harry! He's not relaxing, is he?
Apparently not. He's going to sacrifice himself.
No, you can't! There must be another way!
No one asked your opinion. You filthy little mudblood. You'll pay for that one, Malfoy. Eat slugs!
You okay, Ron? Look at my face.
Look at your tail.
I'm warning you, Hermione. Keep that bloody beast of yours away from Scabbers, or I'll turn it into a tea cozy.
It's a cat, Ronald. What do you expect?
Cat? Is that what they told you? Looks more like a pig with hair, if you ask me.
That's rich, coming from the owner of that smelly old shoe brush. Do you want to move a bit closer?
Huh?
To the Shrieking Shack.
She's gone mental, Hermione has.
I mean, not that she wasn't always mental, but now it's out in the open for everyone to see.
That felt good.
Not good, brilliant.
Wake up, Ronald.
Bloody hell.
Honestly, get dressed.
Where am I? Oh, girl.
Well spotted. I won't be going alone because, believe it or not, someone's asked me.
I think he's got a bit more than friendship on his mind.
What? What? That's what you think?
Yeah, that's what I think.
You know the solution then, don't you?
Go on.
Next time there's a ball, pluck up the courage and ask me before somebody else does. And not as a last resort.
They get scary when they get older.
Ron, you spoiled everything! I'll do the introduction, that's all.
Hermione, you're honestly the most wonderful person I've ever met. If I'm ever rude to you again...
I'll know you've gone back to normal. So you've got the emotional range of a teaspoon.
Oh, I'm hungry.
No!
me down. Now.
You're right.
Fine.
You just stay away from her, all right? I told them I was hungry and wanted some sweets. Of course, they told me to bugger off and ate a lot themselves.
That was clever, Ron.
That's been known to happen.
Will you stop eating? Your best friend is missing.
Oi! Turn around, you lunatic. Sometimes I think that it's better to never ask why. Hermione's got nice skin. It has skin goes, I mean.
Why is it so surprise? You're amazing, you are.
It's always a total surprise. Where's my wand?
I wanted to come back as soon as I left. Just didn't know how to find you. And I heard it. A voice. Your voice, Hermione.
And what exactly did I say, may I ask?
My name. And this tiny ball of light appeared. It floated toward me, the ball of light. Went right to my chest. Straight through me. Right here. I knew it was going to take me where I needed to go, so I disapparated. I came to this hillside.
How long do you reckon she'll stay mad at me?
Just keep talking about that little ball of light touching your heart. She'll come round.
Do you know what I know? Where the light hits the dark, we can brighten the world with the smallest of sparks. Do you see?
Do
I see past the lies and mistakes? We can make or we can break. We've got all that we need.
Hermione! Help me! Come on.